De 18 maanden oude Mani Melvin is geboren met een hersentumor. Een deel van zijn hersenen is buiten zijn schedel gegroeid. De moeder van Mani, Felicia, is van Guyanese afkomst, maar heeft in Suriname gewoond en is hier zwanger geraakt van een Surinaamse man, die echter niets meer van kind nog moeder wil betekenen. In Guyana is er geen hulp voor dit jongetje. De Guyanese artsen hebben hen verwezen naar Trinidad en Tobago, waar medische hulp wel mogelijk schijnt te zijn. Echter zijn de kosten voor de chirurgische ingreep vrij hoog. 400.000 Trinidadiaanse dollars, dat is omgerekend 60.000 US dollar, welke de familie niet kan opbrengen. Ternauwernood zijn ze naar Suriname afgereisd met de bedoeling fondsen te verzamelen voor de operatie van Imani. In Suriname aangekomen werden zij geadviseerd contact op te nemen met Stichting 1 voor 12.
Really asking for help, for people to help this baby. You really need help. This is why I'm here.
What is really the problem with the child?
Well, the baby born with the brains out of the head.
That is what happened. And in Guyana, there is no help for the child.
No.
I get a paper with a very high rate, and the surgery can do, but in Trinidad and Tobago, I understand.
Yes, Trinidad can do the surgery, but Guyana can't do the surgery.
How much is it?
It's 60,000 US.
60,000 US or 400,000 Trinidad and Tobago dollars?
Yes.
And you don't have that money?
No. No.
So, Mama, you head to Suriname to ask for some help. What kind of help you need? Do you need?
I need my son to do his surgery. I'm just asking the public. And anyone who could have children who have feel my pain and my struggling, I just ask them to help me so that my son could do his surgery so he could be normal again. That's all I'm asking, just a help. Please help my son so that I could get him to do his surgery. That's all I wanted, nothing else more.
As we just said, the father is from Suriname. So you think I come to Suriname, there must be a help for this child in Suriname because he's half Surinamese.
Yes, I have needs, yes indeed, but I don't know, they can't take the pressure. Yes, I understand, but I'm this mother, I have feelings, so I can't leave him behind. So the father, he left us in the hospital, said that he doesn't want us anymore because his condition. So I came back to this country to see that my son could get the help here. Because he's half Surinamese.
How bad is his father's condition?
Honestly, I don't know. I don't even know when last I saw him. Because my son is going to be 2 years in September, and I haven't seen him since.
How much do you need now?
I need 60,000 US dollars to help my son. And in Trinidad, it's $450. To help my son do his surgery.
60,000 US dollars to help this child?
Yes. Yes, 60,000. Because he does feel a lot of pain, and you have to take him to the hospital to get treated every time, maybe 2 to 3 times in a week. So we really do need this help.
How do you do with the nursery of this child?
I take him to clinic. I fed him, sometimes I look after him at home. They told me what to do, I do what they said. They said I should clean him with warm water and clean it from any dirt, the same, but they said that he could be outside, you know? So I just take him.
Let the Suriname people hear you cry for help.
Yes. I want them to hear how I'm asking for it, because I really do. I don't want to cry on television because I can't stop crying if I start crying. So I don't want to cry either, because if I do, I wouldn't stop. So I'm just asking for the help. In the name of Jesus, somebody please help me.
Anyone who can help.
Yes, anyone.
All I want to say, it's a very sad story. This story really touches. And I'm begging people, please. Myself also is going to put something towards this. So I'm asking, please help this mother. It could happen to anybody.
So you need the help very urgent for this child.
Yes, because the doctor said the more longer we take, it will, you know, be difficult for him.
How old is he now?
He's 18 months.
And the paper we got here, that's from 3 months ago.
We had to come because I told she this is the only way, because if we can't, we could only help us with our passage and places to stay. I told her if we could come back here, see that we could get some help. And she said, okay, so we had to fix the times, you know, get his medication right before we came back here.
If you indeed, I hope the Surinamese people will help also, and also maybe some other help you get, and you get the money to do the surgery in Trinidad and Tobago. Oh, do you think about the nursery after the surgery?
Yes, I will think do such, because I will take care of him, and I would thank everybody who that helped me. And I will also thank God for keeping him alive for me. So I will take care of him. Anyhow, I would have to get a job after too.
Did the doctors tell you what to do, how to handle the child after the surgery?
Yes. Well, the baby is going to be guided by some of our agents back in Guyana who do healthcare work and so. Red Cross, guidance of them.